Hey guys, welcome to the new video of Eduception. We explained to you the basic things of topography in this video, which include eastings, northings, scales and the grid references. Now topography is very easy if you understand it carefully. So watch the series of videos coming your way and understand it easily. Without further ado, let's start. Now when we see a topographical map, what is the first thing that we notice? We notice certain lines. The red lines, these red lines. Now what are these red lines? First of all, they are called eastings, from here to here. So basically from west to east we go, these are called eastings. The number increase from west to east, 83, 84, 85, 86 and so on and so forth. And what are this? These are the northings. Now the number increases from south towards the north, 91, 92, 93, 94 and so on and so forth. What do they help us with? They help us with the grid references and many other things. Now let me tell you some basic things first. Now this box is basically 2 cm sides. This is 2 cm and this is 2 cm. Okay. So if we have a square of side 2 cm, the area is 4 cm square. So this helps us in that. These are the basic things that we get from eastings and northings. Now to understand topographical maps, you need to understand the scale of your maps first. Now you can see two things over here. This 1:50,000 and this whole scale. Now 1:50,000 is the RF, representative fraction. I'll define it for you later. And this scale is called linear scale and I'll define it for you later. Now let's first look at the definitions, then we will continue with the explanation. Now basically scales are of three types: statement, RF and linear scale. As I mentioned earlier, RF and linear scale are the scales that we used in a topographical map. Now first of all, what is representative fraction? Now RF equals distance on the map divided by distance on the ground. This means that 1 cm on the map equals 50,000 cm on the actual ground. This is the RF we use, that is 1:50,000. Now we have the linear scale. What is linear scale? Linear scale represents the distance on the map. Now let me explain to you what these things actually mean on the map. Now you can see 1:50,000 written. Now what is this? This is the RF. It means that 1 cm on this map equals 50,000 cm on the actual ground. That simply means that 2 cm on this map equals 1 kilometer on the actual ground. Now what you see over here, this black line, this is the linear scale. This is of basically 8 kilometers, or you can also say 7 kilometers. Okay. Now let's see something first. Now let's start with 0 here. This is 0. Now we can see that this comes in 14 centimeters. Now according to the scale, 14 centimeters will give us 7 kilometers. So this scale is correct. Now what does this scale show? The scale coincides with the boxes. Let's use a scale for that. This coincides with 84 and this coincides with 92. So this basically shows the distance on the map to the actual ground. Now you can simply see over here that this is divided into 10 segments. Now this coincides with the whole box. That means this equals 2 centimeters. Now 2 centimeters equals 1 kilometer. Okay. Now basically each segment is 100 meter. So this also shows the scale of the map. So this is basically RF and the linear scale according to your topographical map. Now I will explain to you 4-figure grid reference and 6-figure grid reference. Now why do we use these two things? These two things are basically used to position something on the map. For example, let me show you first. Now how will I say that? How can I find this position, spot height 205? Now there is a technique to this. This is called 4-figure grid reference and also we can use 6-figure grid reference. First of all, I will start with 4-figure grid reference. I'll explain to you this with the help of an example. Now first of all, we take spot height 205. Now what do we see first when we take out a 4-figure grid reference? Now first, we see the eastings. Now the eastings, which is left to the thing which we want to calculate the four figure grid reference, we take that. So we take 95 first. Let me write it over here. It will be good for you to understand. And then we take the northings. Now what northings do we take? We take the northings which is below to it. So what northing is below to it? It's 77. So we write 77. So basically this is the four figured grid reference of spot height 205. 9577. Now I'll show you more examples so that you can understand it properly. Now we will see the four figure grid reference of spot height 542. Now spot height 542 is over here. Let's look at its four figure grid reference. Now first of all, what do we take? We take Eastings first. Always remember that. Take Eastings first and then the Northings. EN. Now which Eastings is left towards it? 97. So we will write 97 first. 97. And what Northing is below to it? It's 82. So 82. So its four figure grid reference will equal 9782. Okay. Now we will do settlement Rampura. Now this is settlement Rampura. I am circling it for you. Now what we take first? We take Eastings. What are Eastings? Eastings left towards it. It's 95. So we write 95 first. And then what are the Northings below to it? It's 80. 80. So the four figure grid reference is 9580. 9580. Now we find the four figure grid reference of Rahavas, this thing, this settlement. Now first what we take? Eastings. The Eastings which is left towards it, it's 90. So first we write 90 and then we see the Northings below it. The Northings below it is 80. 80. Okay, that's good. So the four figure grid reference of Rahavas is 90, this one, and 80, this one. So I think that it will be pretty clear to you what four figure grid reference is. Now we learn how to determine the six figure grid reference of some object on the map. Now what is six figure grid reference first? It is similar to four figure grid reference but with more precision in positioning the particular object or thing on the map. So I'll show you this with an example similar to four figure. Now for example, let's take this spot height 205, this little dot. Okay. Now similar to four figure, first we take the Eastings left towards it, that is 95. Now we write 95, then we leave a space. Okay. Now I'll tell you what this space means afterwards. Now we take the Northings below it. Now Northing below it, it's 77. So we take 77 over here and another dash. Now I will reveal the mysteries of the two dashes over here. Now you need a scale for this, okay? So this is quite confusing, so understand it properly. Now this is the spot, if you can see it. Yes, you can see it. This is the spot. Now as we first take the Easting, we calculate the distance from the Easting to the point in millimeters. It's 5, 6 and 7 millimeters. I don't know if you can see or not. It's 7 millimeters. Okay. Now what do we do? 7 millimeters, we have got this. What do we do? We divide this by 2. So 7 divided by 2 is 3.5. Now we neglect the 0.5. We take the 3. Okay. So this dash, the dash after the Eastings is filled by 3. Okay. Now we take the distance from the Northing to the point. It's around 8. Okay, 8. So 8 divided by 2 is 4. So simply write 4. So this is your 6 figure grid reference. 953774. This is the 6 figure grid reference of spot height 205. I'll explain another thing to you so you can do it properly. Now we find the six figure grid reference of the temple which is present at Rampura. So you can see this, I guess. This is the temple which is present at Rampura. So first we find the Easting which is left towards it. It's 95. So we write 95 over here. then a dash, and we find the northing which is below to it. It's 80, 80. So we write 80 and a dash after that. Now we apply the same process over here. We find the distance from the easting to it. It's 8, I guess. Yes, it's 8. So 8 divided by 2, it's 4. Remember, you have to divide it by 2. It's 4. 8 millimeters divided by 2 is 4. You write that in the dash which is near to the eastings. Now we calculate the distance from the northing. This is around 4. Okay, 12. This is 12. Okay, so 12 millimeters. Now 12 millimeters divided by 2 is 6. So we write 6 here. We dash after the northing. So the 6 figure grid difference is simply 954806. Okay. I hope you have understood both the 4 figure and 6 figure grid reference. Now 4 figure is easy, 6 figure is quite confusing. So practice it, practice all the yearly questions of topography. After solving around 10 to 12 6 figure grid references, it will be easy for you. Now if you have any doubts, please comment down below. I will be more than happy to solve it for you and upload it in the next video. So please comment down below.